Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for Spring 2020. After a dry start to winter, August rainfall was above average for many areas. The rising chance of La Niña means wetter than average conditions are likely for spring across much of eastern Australia. But first, let's look at recent conditions. After a dry start to winter, August was Australia's wettest winter month since 2016. However, southern coastal areas of the mainland and western Tasmania missed much of the rain. August days were very warm across northern Australia, with several locations having days around 40 degrees in northwest western Australia. In contrast, southern Australian states had two cold outbreaks during winter. On the 5th of August, Launceston woke to its most significant snowfall since the early 1970s. Recent rainfall means soil moisture is above average for the Murray-Darling Basin and along the southeastern coast, a large contrast to the dry soils this time last year. However, for parts of southern Australia and western Australia, below average rainfall since April means soil moisture has declined. Warragamba Dam, Sydney's major water storage, reached 100% of capacity in August. Many water storages in the southeast are also continuing to rise. However, storages in southern Victoria, Tasmania, and southwest Western Australia have shown little improvement during winter, which is typically their filling season. So what will influence our climate in the coming months? In recent weeks, we've seen more cooling in the central tropical Pacific Ocean, along with stronger than normal trade winds. These are often early signs of La Niña. As a result, the ENSO outlook has been raised to La Niña alert, meaning the likelihood of La Niña developing is around 70%, roughly triple the normal chance. La Niña typically increases the chance of rainfall in spring across much of Australia. In the Indian Ocean, around half the climate models we survey suggest a negative Indian Ocean dipole for spring. This may also increase spring rainfall. As a result, the spring outlook suggests above average rainfall across much of the eastern two-thirds of the country. The first rains of the northern wet season are likely to be earlier than normal over much of Queensland and the Northern Territory. The streamflow outlook for August to October suggests low to near median streamflows are likely at 80% of locations, with high flows mostly expected in the southeast. With wetter catchments and above average rainfall likely, there is an increased risk of widespread flooding in some parts of the east. Spring days are likely to be warmer than average across northern Australia and in Tasmania, but cooler than average for parts of the southern mainland. Spring nights are likely to be generally warmer than average, except for southwest WA. Frosty nights are still possible, particularly in areas without recent rainfall. So in summary, spring 2020 is likely to see above average rainfall across eastern Australia, warmer than average days in the north, low to near median streamflows at most locations, and increased risk of flooding in some parts of the east. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about our outlooks on our website. We'll see you next time.